Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classrooms. We are studying it related to the aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acids. Today we will be going through the chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones. Now, when we are talking about we are going to study about chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones. Now, when we are going through the chemical properties of the aldehydes and ketones, the first and that is the most important chemical property of aldehydes and ketones that we are going to come across, that is nucleophilic addition reaction. The first, it's a nucleophilic. It means what? Nucleophile. That is going to be added in the reaction. Now, we are having it for aldehydes and ketones, a carbonyl group. The reaction within this carbonyl group is going to take place because it's having it as an one as a pi bond. The pi bond is going to be a weaker bond, so it is going to be broken out very easily. And the nucleophile is going to attack onto this carbonyl group. And so the reaction is termed as a nucleophilic addition reaction. During this case, when this carbonyl group is there, it initially having it as an, this is having a planar structure. In this planar structure, the nucleophile is going to be attacking onto these carbon, right? In such a way that within the plane, it's going to be attacking it on a perpendicular to it. That means this carbonyl group, if we consider it, it's a planar structure. On this planar structure, the nucleophile is going to attack from the perpendicular direction. So as a result, what will happen? Initially, as an intermediate, you will get it as nucleophile and oxygen will become as an negatively charged. That means this electron pair is towards the oxygen and nucleophile comes onto the carbon. This is known as unstable alkoxide because of O minus group. It is termed as an alkoxide. This alkoxide, it's going to react with H plus and gets converted into OH group. Now during this case, initially your carbon which was present in the compound was sp2 hybridized. It was sp2 hybridized and the carbon here, the carbon we are going to get it is sp3 hybridized. That means your compound which was initially a planar get converted into a tetrahedral, right? And during the reaction with a nucleophile, and hydrogen is also going to get added into the compound. And so such type of reactions, we term them as a nucleophilic addition reaction. We are going to get it as a different types of nucleophilic addition reaction, right? This was the mechanism of the nucleophilic addition reaction. Now we want to understand that addition to the mechanism, if I am having it as an aldehydes and ketones, which one is going to react much more faster, right? Then we will come across the different components as a nucleophile that are going it for the reaction. Now, during the reaction, as a nucleophilic reaction, when we take it as an aldehyde, we are having it as an one alkyl aryl and the another one as a hydrogen group. At the same time, in the ketone, we are going to get it as an two alkyl groups, right? Now when your nucleophile, it's going to attack onto the carbon, at that time what happens? This is a smaller group, so this nucleophile can go in the reaction much easier, right, compared to from the upper region. But in the case of this. Here when your nucleophile is going it to the carbon, both being in bulky group, do not allow nucleophile to easily attack on carbon, while in aldehyde we have only one bulky group, therefore nucleophile can attack on carbon easily. Nucleophile can attack onto the carbon easily, and that's the reason why we say that. Thus, reactivity of nucleophile is in order of aliphatic aldehydes. That means RCHO, which are much more reactive than aliphatic ketones. Much greater than aliphatic ketones. That is RCOR, right? So reactivity of aldehydes are more than ketones, or aromatic aldehydes are more than aromatic ketones. Okay, so that is related to the reactivity. Now, the next one that we are going to discuss now, that is different nucleophilic addition reaction. Now, when we are talking about the different nucleophilic addition reactions, which are the different nucleophilic addition reaction that we are going to get it? We are going to come across addition of NaHSO3. The one reaction we are going it for NaHSO3. The second one with HCN. The third one we will be coming it as RMGX. The fourth reaction we will be having it as alcohols. And the fifth one, ammonia and its we are going to study this five different nucleophiles, how they are going to react with aldehydes and ketones. One by one we will come across all the five of them, right? Now let's take it as an first one. NaHSO3, this reaction is also termed as purification of aldehydes and ketones. It's not only the nucleophilic addition reaction of aldehydes and ketones by NaHSO3, we term the same reaction as purification of aldehydes and ketones. Now let's check the reaction, why we term them as an purification also or nucleophilic addition, how the reaction will take place. Now we are having it as an carbonyl group, maybe aldehyde. First of all we will go it for aldehyde and then we will go it for ketone. We will be having it as an NaHSO3 to react with it. During this case, this component initially gets converted into Na plus HSO4 minus, right? This particular component is going to dissociate itself into Na plus HSO4 minus. So this is going to be my nucleophile. HSO4 minus is going to be nucleophile. The component will react and get converted into C single bond O with a valency. This is going to be negatively charged alkoxide. So Na plus will react over there and here HSO4 minus. But during the reaction, actually when we are writing it, HSO4 minus, at that time what will happen? This Na plus will interchange its position because oxygen is more attractive towards the hydrogen, and so it replaces Na and gets rearranged, producing HOH SO3 Na. Sorry, here I just wrote it 4, it's a NaH, right from the beginning I made an error, NaH SO3, SO3 Na, right? Right from the beginning we want to remember that it's a NaH SO3, not NaH SO4, right? We get it as this component, as a nucleophile that is added to it. Now, on acidification, that means on hydrolysis, H2O in presence of H plus, or we'll take it HCl itself. Either you can write it as an HCl, HNO3 or H2SO4, whichever the acid you are having it. On reaction, it produces, aldehyde is obtained back. This component will react to produce NaCl, SO2, H2, it produces NaCl, SO2 and H2O, right? Okay, now this is for the aldehyde reaction. Very small thing, I am not writing it again, but you can remember it, that in place of H, if I put it up, it will become ketone. In place of H, if we place it up, it will become ketone. Then what will happen? The reaction is not going to have any change. It's going to proceed in the similar manner. Same steps, same products, same interchanges, same things are taking place. And so, particularly, starting with aldehyde, we get the product of aldehyde. Starting with ketone, we can get it as a pure ketone obtained back. And therefore, this reaction is also considered as nucleophilic addition reaction. Right? Purification of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, that was your first reaction. Now let's go for the second reaction. Reaction with HCN, that is going to produce cyanohydrin as a product. It's going to produce as a cyanohydrin as a product. Again, we are having it as a carbonyl group. You can convert it as one as alkyl, one as hydrogen, then it will become aldehyde. Both of them as an alkyl or aryl, they will get converted into ketones. So I am just writing now carbonyl group, right? So either may be aldehyde or ketone. If it is reacted with HCN, then again this HCN is going to ionize as H plus CN minus. CN minus being a nucleophile will attack onto the carbonyl carbon, and hydrogen will go on to the compound with oxygen, which is COH and CN. The particular compound is known as cyanohydrin. This cyanohydrin, this is an additional reaction that you will have to remember. Right, wherever you are having it as an CN group, and if I go it for reduction with H2 in presence of Ni or maybe AlH4, what will happen? The compound OH and this CN will get converted into CH2NH2. Right, this is CN if I am going it for reduction. But again, if I go it for hydrolysis in limited portion, only one H2O is indicated with restricted, then at that time the compound will get converted into CONH2, amide. It will produce amide. CONH2. And if you go it for hydrolysis in excess quantity, then at that time the compound gets converted into COOH. So all these reactions are of CN group, which you can remember, CN group. Wherever you are having CN group, reduction, hydrolysis in limited portion or in excess, you are going to get either amine, either acid, or either as a neutral compound. Base, acid, as well as neutral, all the three can be produced from CN group, right? And this is a particular reaction of cyanohydrin. This is only the cyanohydrin reaction. These are the additional reactions that are given to you, because in the exam we can have it as an give the conversions of following compounds. So at that time the compounds, they, we can have it this particular reactions, right? Okay, third one, with Grignard reagent, third we will come it across R and GX. This is known as Grignard reagent that we are using it. By this reaction, it is also termed as preparation of primary, secondary, tertiary alcohol. That means we have studied the same reaction in our previous chapter, right? That is preparation of primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols. But still, as in a part of the study, we will revise it again. If we are having it as in a carbonyl group, right? Now this particularly only formaldehyde produces primary alcohol. Rest of aldehydes produces secondary alcohol. Rest of the aldehydes are going to produce secondary alcohols, and ketones produces tertiary alcohols. Now this is going to be very important to remember. If I am having it as an formaldehyde, whichever the Grignard reagent, whichever RMGX, it's an immaterial. If the given component is formaldehyde, it's always going to produce primary alcohol. If your this carbonyl group, it's other than formaldehyde, other than methanol. In that means, if we don't have it both as hydrogen, one is alkyl, one is hydrogen, then we are going to get it as secondary alcohols. And if we are having it as an ketones, both of them as an the alkyl or aryl group, we are going to get it as an tertiary alcohols. Now let us take it as an example. If we write it a different example, I'm just erasing it. Let's take it as an example. Methanol reacts with RMGX. It's going to produce OMGXR, which on hydrolysis goes to produce primary alcohol, right? Other than that, one is alkyl or aryl and another one is hydrogen. Other than the formaldehyde, we will get it as RMGX reacted with it, we get it as HR OMGX R dash, which on hydrolysis produces RCHOH R dash, secondary alcohols. While if we take it as ketones, we get it as reaction of ketones to produce tertiary alcohols, right? These reactions, particularly in our textbook, in chapter number 11, they have been written. For chapter number 12, they have simply indicated in our textbook that this is in your previous chapter. So you can go through it, and these are the reactions that we are going to get it. This particular reaction, we remember it as nucleophilic addition reaction for RMGX, as well as it is also termed as preparation of primary, secondary or tertiary alcohol. So same question, answer is one and the same, but two different questions that can be generated for it. So it's necessary that you remember both the conditions, right? Okay, the fourth one that we are having it, the fourth reaction, that is with alcohols. Now, alcohols, we know it that if I am having it as an only one OH group, that is monohydric alcohols, then they can react with aldehydes. Ketone does not give reaction. Ketone does not react. Aldehydes and ketones, when reacts with dihydric alcohols, then they produce cyclic compounds, which are known as cyclic ketals or cyclic acetals, right? Let's see it, how these are the particular reactions that are taking place. When we are having it as an aldehyde reacted with R-OH, initially it gets converted into RCH alkoxide, initially an intermediate alkoxide, from which it reacts with ROH, hemiacetal. The product, it's a partial. Hemi means partial. So it's a half of it is getting converted into acetal. This compound, when it's furtherly reacted with our second alcohol, we get it as OR dash, OR double dash. This is acetal. We get it as an acetal product. But this is monohydric alcohol, so that can react only with aldehydes. If we take it as an dihydric alcohols, then with a single reaction, they get converted into cyclic ketones. This is cyclic acetal, because here you are having an aldehyde group. Now in place of that, if you are having it as a ketone, ketone can react over here because it's an dihydric alcohol, and over there it will also produce the similar type of cyclic ketones. So dihydric produces cyclic compounds, while monohydric produces simply acetals. They can't produce ketones, right? Okay, this was your fourth reaction. The fifth nucleophilic addition reaction, that is ammonia and its derivatives. ammonia and its derivatives means if we are having it as an NH3, and if one of the hydrogen of NH3 is replaced by some other functional group, then we consider it as NH2Z. Z is some functional group, right? You can say that during this aldehydes and ketones, maybe aldehydes or maybe ketones, both of them, they react with in acidic medium. That time the compound gets converted into double bond NZ and H2O. It's given out as byproduct. It's removed out in the form of H2O. So at that time, though it is a nucleophilic addition reaction, there should be a carbonyl group present in it. But this is an additional reaction in which you can say that the water is removed out, oxygen is removed, and nucleophile is attacked in place of oxygen. Right? These reactions are also considered as condensation reactions. We generally term them as condensation reactions, but in our textbook it is given out as a nucleophilic addition reaction for ammonia and its derivatives. So we'll study it in the same way. Now this Z, it can be OH, it can be NH2, it can be NHC6H5, whichever the component may be there as a Z, it's going to produce the product. If it is an ZN, Z as an OH, it's going to get converted as NOH. This particular compound is known as oxime, right? Now, in place of OH, if it is NH2, then you are going to get it as NNH2, hydrazone, right? Similarly, phenyl hydrazone or carbazide or Schiff's base, all these different functional groups with an example, it's indicated in your textbook. You can go through any of these Z group in the examination for the product. You can be asked any of it. Remember the condition that this reaction is carried out in acidic medium. That is must. Okay. So, like that, you can come across the different nucleophilic addition reactions. These are all the nucleophilic addition reactions that are given in our textbook, right? In our next lecture, we will be discussing it about other chemical reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Till then, thank you.